one preaching that I wish if I could kneel on my knees with folded hands, plead with each one of you. Because in this word, I was able to grasp the heart of God. I said, God, I don't want, you know what, I'm not a preacher who speaks doom of honest people. I never do that. Because I've come to a realization, if ever I curse my people, then I have to deal with them afterwards. It's a headache. I want my people to be blessed. But having said that, I want to bring this forth from my heart to your heart, because I sense in my spirit, for some people, it could be tonight. I don't want to say the word never, but maybe the cycles will come. But after many years later, you would miss on the cycle of seasons of God. So here tonight I stand also as a prophet of God with a message that is imploring you to take it serious. We had such celebrations in the house of the Lord. And I believe celebrations will happen even tonight.
Amen.
You put me out there on the platform to even preach a sermon of judgment, people will still praise God. We'll have joy. Because God's word always has encouragement.
Amen.
So I know that. So tonight there's going to be a great, I believe, if you're talking about response, tonight some of you are going to let loose yourselves. But it comes with a word of caution. I want you to go to the book of 2 Corinthians. I know this has also been recorded for our international audience. 2 Corinthians, chapter 10 and verse number 3 to 5. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, 3 to 5. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. The next word. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty. Somebody used the word mighty. Through God, to the pulling down of strongholds. When people use the word carnal or carnality, most often the image that you know pops in your head is image of somebody who is recklessly sensual, who is belligerent, who is kind of, you know, has no, you know, any form of restraint, a carnal person. But that's not what the Bible means by that word. The Bible's definition of that word is simple. It's much more closer to our hearts, to our lives. It means somebody who handles matters depending on the five senses. Now we know this word is not alien to many of us. It is not a word that is a foreign word, because many a times we try to employ the sense as we see it deemed fit to counter issues. But the Bible says our warfare is not based on the five senses. It is spiritual weapons. Somebody lift up your voice and say, spiritual weapons. Mighty through God. To bring down strongholds. That means we do have weapons from God to bring down strongholds. What do you mean by stronghold? Now I want you to look at me, please. A stronghold essentially means, in the Roman context, as Paul being a Roman citizen himself, a stronghold means when the enemy invades a place, the enemy will get one little place which would become the place that the enemy can be safe. He will build an impregnable fortress, a fortress that is mighty, and from that fortress, you know, no matter how many people are around him to attack him, he's safe in that fortress. And from that fortress, he will strategize. From that fortress, he will send out his ammunitions. From that fortress, he will control every aspect of warfare. Did you get what I'm trying to say? It is like a bunk where the enemy cannot easily attack. How many of you know when America went for the war, or the West went against Saddam Hussein? I was traveling in some of those places. Even today, we can see strong fortresses of the American Army or Air Force in some countries today. From there, that's the safest place they will launch. They will have their control center. But what I want you to know, what is so painful and frightening, the Bible says the enemy has such a fortress that he has made against you. But what was so much frightening to my spirit, the Lord told me, tell my people, the stronghold is not on the outside. He has made a stronghold inside your mind. And from there he's attacking you. Many times we say, God, the enemy is attacking me from that person, this situation, that corner, this place. But God told me tonight, tell my people, they are the greatest fortress of the enemy against you is in your mind. But I heard a joyful, consoling word from Jesus tonight. By the power of the Holy Spirit, tonight some of those age-old fortresses in your mind is going to be pulled down by the power of a living God. If you believe that, shout a hallelujah in the house of the Lord. So everybody, if you believe this, can you put your hand on your head as if you're touching your mind and declare over your mind, every fortress of the enemy, let it be pulled down tonight. Come on, speak out. Every fortress, can you imagine, the enemy is not attacking from the outside. He has got a fortress inside your mind. But tonight, by the blood of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Ghost, this stronghold has to come tumbling down. If you believe, there is power in the Holy Spirit, weapons that God has given you, can you make a sound of joy? You are the Word. But then the enemy wants to build a stronghold. He does not want the Word to infiltrate the mind. He wants to build a stronghold and prevent this word. So then the next verse will get this secret out to you. Look at, if you want to pull down these strongholds, you'll have to pull down three things. Amen. Three things. Everybody say three things. Say it loudly. If you want the stronghold to come down, oh, I tell you, people of God, some of you are going to go into a release in your life based on the word of God. I'm not talking about prophecy. I'm talking about the power of God's word. If you believe that, shout a hallelujah in the house of the Lord. Now listen. You know, three things that need to be pulled down in order for the stronghold to come down. Because you cannot attack the stronghold directly. You cannot say, in the name of Jesus, stronghold, come down. It is not going to work. You can attack a stronghold on the outside. But in the inside, it is more complicated than that. So instead of attacking the stronghold, you'll have to bring down three things. When those three things come down, the stronghold is going to come down tonight. Come on, how many of you want to bring down? How many of you know God has given us the weapon mighty enough? Hallelujah. Oh, you didn't hear that. Can I get a glorious shout of praise in the house of the Lord? God has given us weapons mighty enough to bring down the stronghold. Now listen, the first one, you know, the problem with us, manifestations of the stronghold look so benign that we would have a tendency to overlook it. Because when we talk about stronghold, we are saying witchcraft, sorcery. But God says that is not the biggest problem. I want to make it very clear. Your biggest enemy is not on the outside. Oh, you didn't hear that. I said your biggest enemy is not on the outside. He is on the inside. And tonight he has to come down. Hallelujah. Because when we look at those three things, we are going to know for sure we were having these things as pet in our lives. We thought they were benign things. And some of us were proud that we had this. Number one, casting down imaginations. The word imagination in the Greek is a word which is logismos. Logismos. God says if you want to bring down the stronghold, you'll have to bring down logismos. Logismos is from where you get the word logic. When somebody speaks loudly and confidently, you know what? I am not stupid. I'm a logical person. Come on. We are making some inroads. Let me tell you, somebody needs encouragement. This is one night I want somebody to say, preach, Pastor.
Oh, hallelujah.
Logic. You know, logic is celebrated. You know, many times I want to be a logical person because the opposite of logic to me, I'm an idiot. I don't want to come across as an idiot. I want to be logical. I've heard people, you know what? I'm not like the other person. I'm more logical. But let me tell you, the enemy uses logic against the truth of God's word. Tonight, you are not living a life. The Lord told me that two words that are connected. One is logos. The other one is logismos. Logos means word. Logismos means logic. Tonight we are breaking down logismos and we are receiving the logos of the word of God. Hey.
Hallelujah.
Somebody. Now, how many of you have heard or even said this? I want to be logical. You know, if you're ashamed, I will lift my hands. But Lord told me, some of the things that I'm going to speak to you cannot be addressed by logic. I'll give you one example. You know, God said to Moses, when they're having a warfare, the Amalekites have come. In Exodus chapter 17, God told Moses, the battle is going to happen in the valley. But the battle is going to be controlled on the mountain. Come on.
Hallelujah.
How can that be logic? If God had told Moses, I give you a sword and I'm going to give you a super sword, and you just have to go and fight. That is more logical. But God said, you don't have to fight. You just sit on the mountaintop. Come on. And you just have to lift your hand. Every time you lift your hand, your people are getting victory. Hallelujah. It is not logical, but it is an act of faith.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Can you imagine how illogical it would sound to the modern people? You sit on the mountain and it's based. Can I have... If I get to a chance with Obama, and I tell Obama, the whole victory is based on the movement of your hand in your bedroom, he would immediately call his private guards and say, get this guy out. Come on, doesn't make any sense. Can you imagine God putting Moses in such a situation? And the Lord told me, I'm going to teach my people. Sometimes what I say might not make sense logically. In the days to come, some of you, while praying here, your miracle is going to happen miles away. In the name of Jesus. Can somebody lift up your voice and say, it might not sound logical, but nothing is impossible with my God. Oh, Abba Shakandala. Woo! You know, the other day, Pastor Dino and I don't know who all went with him, illogical guys, went through the city of Edmonton, and they went around neighborhood and started to wave their hand into the neighborhood and said, this place belongs to Jesus. Let me tell you, if anybody were to see my co-pastor, they would have called 911. I want to declare it's so illogical, but tonight I say it was done as an act of faith. God is saying some of you have a fortress of the devil, and because of the fortress, no miracles are happening because you have a tendency to look at everything logically. But tonight the Lord says, I'm going to raise up a generation who will say, it doesn't make sense, but the word of God is above every logic. Come on. Can I get somebody who will push their faith tonight? If God were to say, lift up your voice and shout a mighty hallelujah, your children are going to be saved. Can you trust the word of God over your life? And let me tell you, it might not sound as logic, but it is a word of God. Hey. The Lord told me recently, by pondering and by contemplating, by reflecting, by introspecting, by doing all that, you are not going to get a miracle. It is when you act on my word.
Hallelujah.
If Moses had, sat there mumbling to himself, sitting there and trying to figure out what is the logic behind it, it's not going to work. He just lifted up his hand. When he could not lift his hand, two illogical guys came and lifted up his hand. Hey, is anybody in this place who are people who are not led by logic but by the word of God? Can I get... Oh, you didn't hear that. I am asking, is anybody in this place who would say, logic does not make sense, but the word of God is powerful enough? Oh, come on. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Hey, Moses had two people. Let me tell you, if God tells me you don't have a bank balance, your church is not big enough, but I'm going to give you a bill. Not building, but buildings, which might even cost $10 million. I'm going to declare like Moses, Lord, I will not just lift my hand. I want the whole earth to know I believe in the word of God. Is anybody who wants to support your pastor? Hey, somebody, come on, hallelujah. It is the spirit of logic that needs to break down in the land of Canada. I heard recently our new Pope has a difficulty, it seems, trying to believe the creation as it happened in the Bible. He wants to believe somehow an evolutionary Big Bang happened. Let me tell you something. Pope is a very wise man, smart man. Let him have all those logics. But tonight here is a man from India declaring if God said it, it is done. He doesn't need anything else because his word is powerful enough. If I can get somebody who will associate not with the logic of your mind but with the word of God, can you shout an agreement, amen, in the house? Hey, the Lord asked me a question. Son, can you tell me the logic of people simply shouting and the walls of Jericho coming down? The Lord told me, can you tell me the logic out of physics that an axe, a metal axe, does not sink? Instead of going down, it's coming up. How can you say that? How can you even try to understand it? Forget explaining it. The Lord told me, how can you explain to a lady who is about to have a last meal, and then with that meal she's going to die, and the prophet Elijah comes and says, that meal you give to me and you're going to live? How can you explain to Martha, Mary, if Jesus were to come before my son died, that before my brother died, that was okay. But now, logically, he is thinking. But the Lord says tonight, you want to see the next move of God? Somebody needs to declare logically. It doesn't make sense, but I am walking not on logic, but on the word of God. If I have got somebody in this place, can I get some express? Come on, you can do better. You can do better. You can do better. Tonight, the spirit of logic is going to be broken, because in the days to come, you're going to pray for people who are dying with cancer. You're going to say, it is done in the name of Jesus. Hey. Oh, can I say this? Brothers and sisters, I believe with all of my heart, when the next move of God will happen, I tell you, when somebody is getting a dead body ready to do funeral service, the man of God gets a word from God. And he goes and says, stop this funeral, because the funeral service has been suspended. This man, he is getting up from the coffin by the power of a living God. Is there anybody who will put the word of God above your logic? Can I get? Yay. Can I get a shout in the house of the Lord? Pastor, it doesn't make sense, but I believe the word of God. So I'm going to give you one moment. This is going to be the decisive moment for your future. Tonight, the Lord says, the enemy wants to build logic against the power of God. But I am releasing somebody who will say, logically, it is illogic. It doesn't make sense. But I strongly believe, whatever God said, if he said cancer will be healed, I believe it. The doctors might have a different opinion, but I believe it. If he said this is impossible, I believe it. My God's word trumps over every logic. If you believe that, can I get that one moment? where you're going to release your faith for every enemy to know. Come on, hallelujah. You can do something right now. Come on, you can do something. We are pulling down the stronghold that is preventing miracles from happening in Canada in the name of. Pray. Shabalaba, Shandalaraba, Shandalaraba. Let's get going. Let's get going. The Lord says, the Lord is removing the stronghold that is preventing. I tell you, people who are qualified, people who are really intellectual people are going to flow in the Holy Ghost. You don't have to be stupid to be used by God. Let me tell you, all that you need is a faith like a child faith. God, I don't know how it's going to happen, but I know you can do all things. Can I get somebody tonight? This is a moment of miracles being released. This is a moment of the supernatural being released in the house of the Lord. But tonight the Lord says, before it can happen, the logic spirit must be uprooted in the name of Jesus. If anybody wants to walk in the supernatural, can you do something right now? Supernatural. It's not what your eyes see. It's not what your ears hear. You are going to hear the word of God. If God says tomorrow, you believe tomorrow. If God says the dead is going to come back alive, you believe it. Is anybody in this place who has been praying, Lord, we want to see miracles happen in Canada? We hear it in Africa and other places, but we want to see miracles happen in Canada. And tonight, we are going to bring down the spirit of logic in the name of Jesus. Can only those people make yourself known, conspicuous in the house of the Lord? Tonight, we are releasing the anointing of the supernatural, not by might, not by power, but by the spirit of the Lord. Come on, get ready. Yes. 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 In the name of Jesus. I come against the spirit of logic. Every time God says something, you put on the logic. And I'm going to make a declaration. Some of you will not see in the natural, but you will see it in the spiritual. And what you declare in the spiritual will happen in the natural. Do you want such anointing? If you want that, somebody just latch on to that word. What you see in the spiritual will happen in the natural. Jesus said, what you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. What you loose on earth shall be loosened in heaven. I've only started. Linda, I don't think I'll get to your part. But thank you anyways. The stronghold is coming down. But no, you're not going anywhere. I'll pray with you. Linda, come back. Linda, honey, come back. Hallelujah. We are going to pray tonight in the name of Jesus. Are you ready? The stronghold. Second word. You know what? The second word is this word. Every high thing. Meaning logic will lead to the next step called pride. I know better. And this is a point where the Lord told me, tell my people. That's making the devil build a stronghold. People of God who will say, God, you said it. Your word said it. And you use the servant of God to say it. And I'm going to say yes to it. Pride. God says something and you say, I know better. How many of you know the word of God says, your thoughts are not above God's thoughts? I want to declare today, God's thoughts are always higher. Can I get a witness? God's ways are always higher. Can you believe that tonight? And the Lord told me, one man who became a demonstration of this beautiful truth. His name is Peter. Jesus came to Peter and said, Peter, cast your net on the right side, on that side. Logic kicks in. Master, we toiled through the night, caught nothing. Logic. You know what the logic? Fishes are caught in Galilee in the night. If you ever want to catch fish, it's in the night. Because under the sunlight, fishes don't come. So Peter is using his logic. If I did not catch fish in the night, how can I catch fish in the daylight? But I heard the Lord say tonight, this is the moment. After saying his logic, which was a true logic, Peter made a statement. Nevertheless. At your word. Because logic would lead to pride. That's what happened to Pharaoh. Who is this God that I should hear him? Who is this God that I should obey his voice? Logic, pride. But here is a man who gave his logic, but immediately surrendered. Something told him, you have some, the one standing before you is a logos. The word that became flesh. If he can create the whole universe out of nothing, doesn't matter if it is daylight or if those, all the fishes in Galilee have gone on a vacation, doesn't matter. I will bring them back. I saw a vision right now. Jesus is waiting and ready to do a miracle. Jesus is about to do a miracle for your family. Meaning, what you did not get after many days of toiling, he can bring it forth. What you could not gather over many years, God wants to release one word and bring it forth. Your healing is coming forth. Your miracle is coming forth. Your children's blessing is coming forth. But God says, is anybody who can say, logically, God, this does not make sense. I don't even agree with it. My mind does not agree with it. But tonight, at your word, I will do it. Come on. If that's your prayer, can I get somebody to lift up your voice and shout a hallelujah in the house of the Lord? Logically, it doesn't make sense. But I believe your word. Let's say, Jesus already spoke that word. Can you just stand there for a minute? Jesus all, you know, spoke that word. And the fishers got the word. And they're just waiting. All the fishers are arrested. I see in my spirit, some of your miracles have been arrested. It cannot move. Some of the things that you've been praying for, God has frozen it. It cannot escape anymore. This fasting prayer, he has done it. It could be your finance, it could be your ministry, it could be your children's deliverance. The Lord is telling me, tell my people, I have frozen it for them. I have arrested it for them. It cannot leave that place. It cannot go out from that place. It has been arrested. But God says, tonight you have got a choice. When you said, Jesus, Doesn't make sense. I did it through the night, nothing happened. I tell you, all the fishes are waiting. Because Jesus' word has already gone. The Lord says he's not going to repeat his word. His word has already gone. And I came here with a very powerful word. Some of the miracles that you're praying for, Jesus has already spoken the word. It is only a matter of time before that word and the miracle is going to enter your boat. Come on. Hallelujah. The word has already gone. But what is the matter? It is one word of yours that's going to see if that fish that Jesus has pulled together by supernatural power, are they going to enter your boat or are they going to go back? And today you are representing whatever miracle the people of God are praying in this place. And here is the moment. Jesus, you said a promise. Doesn't make sense, Lord. Because I know it cannot happen. And the fishers are waiting for your next word. But nevertheless, at your word, I will cast the net. The moment Peter did, all the fishes that were waiting for your next word. Somebody, this is mighty. All the fishes that came at the command of Jesus that were waiting for your next word, they are waiting for the net to come. They're waiting for your net to come. They will not run away from your net. You are going to receive it in the name of Jesus. If you believe that, can you shout in agreement, amen, in the house? Let me pray. The Lord says your miracle is waiting. But tonight, it's your faith that's going to make that miracle that is waiting outside of you to bring it into your net. God said, now, when the fishes are waiting, it's my miracle. But when they get into your net, it's going to become your miracle. Somebody receive it. God says, I'm going to make my miracle. I don't need your word to bring my miracle. But for my miracle to become your miracle, you have to speak a word tonight. You have to speak a word tonight. Can I get somebody who knows what I'm saying to respond in faith in the name of Jesus? Get ready. Get ready. But Suresh, stay there. For some of you, Jesus says the miracle is nations. Oh, you didn't hear that. The miracle is nations. For some of you, the miracle is a supernatural ministry. For some of you, the miracle is a financial breakthrough. For some of you, the miracle is a children's deliverance. No, whatever the miracle is, the Lord says, I have arrested. I have already made it my miracle. It is staying waiting for you. But the next word, which is a word of humility. God, I'm going to place my logic at your feet. And I am going to honor your word. Your word is above my logic. Only those people, the next 2 minutes, God says, the miracle that I have established for you is going to get into your net. I have planned for you what you can't even comprehend. Your heart cannot even accept it. I have planned for you. But God says, what I have planned in the unseen, what I have reserved in the unseen, tell my people within the next few days, it's going to come to the scene, into your boat, come on, into your net. If you believe that, put your hands together. Give the Lord a shout of praise in the house. Oh, this is a prophetic word. Come on, this is a prophetic word. Anybody in this place who believes what God has planned for my life, I'm going to receive it. I'm going to see it. I'm going to put it into my boat. If you believe that, give the Lord a shout. That's going to make the devil know you are a man led by the word of God. Shandarararaba, shandalaraba, shand. Shall we pray? Shall we pray? The logic of your mind is getting broken. The logic has been broken. That stronghold is coming down. The stronghold is coming down. Yes, you don't, it doesn't make sense, but you still say, God, I receive your word. I still receive your word. Only those people with a childlike faith. Come on. Childlike faith. The Pharisees didn't get it. The scribes didn't get it. The lawyers did not get it. The religious people did not get it. But let me tell you, the poor fishermen, disciples, they knew he's a son of a living God. Come on, hallelujah. It doesn't make sense. But let me tell you, is anybody with a childlike faith tonight and say, my God's word is above every situation? If you believe that, can you make yourself known in the house of the Lord? I'm not talking about a corporate worship. I'm talking about an individual. Come on, individual worship in the house of the Lord. You will pray for the sick and they're going to be healed. You will cast out demons and they're going to go out in the name of Shantala Rabashan. Pray, pray, pray. I want only those people who wants to enter. The Lord says, I've already prepared supernaturally. It's already done. It's already done. But now the matter is whether it remains there arrested or will it enter your net. Anybody that wants to say, everything that God has planned for me, I'm receiving it tonight. In the name of Jesus. I'm going to repeat that once again. Somebody in this place, as a sign that the power of logic, however smart it might make you look, is now broken. I'm willing to become a fool for Jesus. Only those people. Can you make something as an action tonight? Hallelujah. The Lord says, by your action of faith, you are going to release those fishes, those miracles into your net in the name of. Hey, do something right now. Do something. I tell you, people of God, you can become a fool for the word of God tonight. I'm asking you tonight, there's a stronghold of the logic that's preventing your miracle. Yes, you also spoke logic, but tonight you're going to say, nevertheless. Come on. Lord, outside my logic, I believe your word. Father, as your servant, I'm declaring a season where what God has already prepared in the supernatural, which no eyes have yet seen, no ears have yet heard, it is about to be seen. Come on, you didn't hear that. I said it's about to be seen. It's not just seen. Your friends are going to see it. Your neighbors are going to share in it. Your family is going to rejoice in it. Can I get a shout of amen? The Lord says, what I have planned for you is glorious. What I have planned for your family is glorious. What I have planned for your future is glorious. What I have planned for your children is glorious. I have already brought the fish that you said you did not find yesterday. It has come today. It has come now. Udaraba, your healing has come now. Your miracle has come now. Shandalaraba, shandalaraba, shanda. I want you to run out of that despair that you have. I want you to move out of that logical spirit. God, I am quite tired. I have been doing this for the whole night. I'm tired. But tonight Jesus is looking at you. Peter, speak the golden word. Peter, speak the next golden word. Peter, the next word will decide your destiny. But tonight we are coming against that first stronghold. Logismos. Tell the Lord, God, I have not had success for the last many years, but I still believe your word. The Lord is waiting for the next word out of your mouth. Somebody, in spite of your tiredness, in spite of your discouragement, lift up your voice as a voice of faith in the house of the Lord. I've never heard the Lord give me such an imminency in the possession of your promise. God said, I've all released it. The fish that you said, you didn't get it. You didn't find it. It's not there. God said, it is waiting now. At a distance, close to you. Oh, you didn't hear that. At a distance where you can reach it. Oh. The Lord says some of the things that were so far away. Tonight it's so close. It is so close. It is so close. But it is still hidden. But God says your next word and your action, you need a word that will go from the scene. Just like the net went from the scene into the unseen. The Lord says, do you have something tonight that will go from the scene into the unseen? Come on, it could be a word, it could be a praise, it could be an action that will go from the scene into the unseen. And when it goes from the seen to the unseen, the Lord says, those fishes are coming in. Those fishes are coming in. Receive it. So on the count of three, I'm going to ask you to do something which will be purely based on faith, which will go from the seen to the unseen. Are you ready? Come on, are you ready? Anglexery, would you please come forward on the platform? Are you ready? It'll go from the seen into the unseen. It could be one word. It could be one exclamation. One faith statement. One, you know, shake hand. Something which will be a word of faith. An action of faith. Because it doesn't make sense otherwise. But the Lord says that word will go and fetch it. Are you ready? It is so close, but that word is going to fetch it. That shout is going to fetch it in the name of Jesus. So let me declare it. On the count of three, I'm going to ask you to do it. Release your faith. You can say, even in the name of Jesus Christ, I receive it. Say something tonight which will be act of faith. One. Two. Three. Oh, come on, somebody. Because it's coming into your net. You are touching the unseen right now. It's coming into your net in the name of Jesus. Come on, rejoice in the presence of the Lord. Your ministry is coming in. Your ministry of future is coming in. Come on, receive it. Oh, Rabba, Rabba, Shakanda, Rabba, Shandala, Rabba, Shantala, Rabba, Shandala, Rabba, Shantala, Rabba, Antalo, Rabba, Shantalo. It's coming in the name of... What no eye has seen is about to become your testimony.